We're following yet another storm about to hit just hours after the record-breaking blizzard. And tonight, a view we haven't seen. This image from NASA this evening, the East Coast lit up there on the left, that monster storm now off to sea. But this is what it left behind, up to 3 feet of snow, a blanket of white across the Northeast tonight. And the devastation from the ground this evening, the floods, the homes and cars covered in ice, inside, homes destroyed. In a moment, meteorologist Ginger Z with the next system across several states. But first tonight, meteorologist Rob Marciano, live in Marshfield, Massachusetts. And what a stunning scene there, Rob.
Indeed, David. I tell you what, the New England coastline just got crushed by this storm. Some of these homes in Marshfield likely to be condemned. Massive waves, huge winds, just devastating this coastline. And this seawall, meant to protect these homes, just a crumbled, mangled mess tonight.
Tonight, the frozen Massachusetts coastline looks like a war zone. The region now buried in deep snow and bracing for more. In Marshfield, blizzard conditions for 14 hours straight, encasing everything in ice. Fisherman Timothy Mannix assessing the damage to his house and himself. He broke his nose when a massive wave crashed right through his home.
This was quite a bit of damage, though. That front wall there never caved in before.
The National Guard rescuing residents from flooded homes. Thousands still without power. Utility workers today hammering away ice to try to clear power lines. Further inland, record-breaking snow. Worcester, over 34 inches. In Auburn, you can barely see the street signs. Hudson, Mass. Got 3 feet too, enough to trap residents inside their homes. In Nashua, New Hampshire, firefighters racing to clear buried hydrants. And in Boston, where schools are closed again tomorrow, they're digging out from the biggest January snowfall on record. That's where we found Stephanie Turner this morning, her first winter in Boston, shoveling for 4 hours to get her car out.
There's no point. The whole street, everything, it's, I can't even get through this.
Two, three.
We decided to give her a hand.
Good job.
Now the bad news is.
No, I gotta go to work.
No, you gotta go to work.
And with the cold firmly entrenched, a warning. If you want to warm up your car, don't leave it unattended. In Indianapolis, more than 11 cars left running, stolen. Back in Marshfield, the reality of the destruction setting in.
This is horrible. We walked this wall yesterday and it's gone.
David, the full-time residents that do live here are spending the night elsewhere. And yes, look at these icicles. This is all seawater that has encrusted these homes. That is how cold it is. Cold enough to freeze salt water. And it's only going to get colder tonight.
Yeah, with David? Those temperatures, it's not going to melt anytime soon. Rob Marciano leading us off tonight. Rob, thank you. Let's get right to your partner, meteorologist Ginger Z, with this next system. Not as big, but not welcome either.
No, even an inch or 3 inches, nobody wants to see it, especially in those places hardest hit. Let me take you straight to the maps, David, because this system is a tomorrow system. It's coming through Thursday. You can see mostly rain south of Pittsburgh, but there. We stopped it at 6 p.m. Washington, D.C. should be on the warmer side, as should New York, but snow to the north. So how much snow can you expect? The heaviest snow totals will be for parts of northern New England. That's where you find the 4+. But yes, Boston in the 1 to 2 inch range. And another story we have not had time yet to talk about this week, the heat, record heat, an all-time January record high in Topeka, Kansas today at 78. Next natural question, is it coming east? The answer is no. You're looking at Saturday morning wind chills 20 below is what it'll feel like in central Pennsylvania.
Tale of two countries tonight. Ginger, thank you.